Jerusalem is a cradle of religions, sacred to the three Abrahamic faiths, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Their shared heritage, however, creates the potential for conflict over the city's sacred spaces, with none more contested than the Temple Mount, known to Muslims as Haram al-Sharif. Conflicts over holy sites often are employed to achieve political ends, a problem intensified when questions of sovereignty are involved, whether Crusaders versus Arabs 1,000 years ago or Israelis versus Palestinians today. Still, evidence of shared spaces and tolerance in Jerusalem dates to the Middle Ages, when disputes often involved different Christian denominations, perhaps a precursor to the current conflicts within Judaism over the place of women and egalitarian prayer at the Western Wall. In modern times, Jerusalem has seen repeated efforts to define and maintain the status quo. In the middle of the 19th century, the Ottoman Sultan Abd al-Majid launched an investigation into competing Christian claims to the Holy Sepulchre. The resulting decree in 1856 gave precedent to the Orthodox Christian claims and froze the existing situation. That emphasis on the status quo was extended to other holy places. The advantage of the legal endorsement of the status quo is that it voids clashes and diffuses conflict by freezing the situation at one point in time. The disadvantages are that one group gains hegemony or exclusivity, minority faiths feel discriminated against, and those minorities don't give up on their claims. They just bide their time waiting for a changing of the guard. Because of the lingering tensions, the status quo, despite its name, doesn't stay static for long. Efforts to maintain the status quo themselves introduce new elements that upset the balance. For example, when Israel added metal detectors and security cameras outside the Temple Mount to maintain the situation within the compound, Muslims responded with civil disobedience and violence. Since Israel's victory in the 1967 war brought all Jerusalem under its control, access to and preservation of the Temple Mount compound have dominated discussions about shared sacred spaces. The 32-acre compound, where Jewish temples were destroyed by conquerors in 586 BCE and 70 CE, is the site of Al-Aqsa Mosque and the Dome of the Rock. With the exception of rare closures for security reasons, Muslims have been granted full access for worship. But rumors and threats of changes, led by the claim that Al-Aqsa is in danger, arise over and over again, but Israeli law bars Jews from praying on the Mount, and many Jews observe a rabbinic ruling banning visits to the Mount. Respect for the status quo is different at the foot of the Mount in front of the Western Wall. Israel has faced pressure to provide in an area for egalitarian prayer, now allowed near Robinson's Arch on the south side of the complex, and to permit women to pray without limits, including chanting from the Torah. Thus, the struggles over shared spiritual spaces are at least as active and persistent, and sometimes as violent among Jews by the Western Wall, as they are between Muslims and Jews atop the Temple Mount compound.